Hey guys, this is Mark. In this lecture, we will make our first baby step in the process of learning codeless programming. And guess what? It is going to be, yes, the Hello World application. Every single book that is written out there on learning programming languages, I think starts with the Hello World. And we don't want to be the exception because I think the history has proven that really that's where people need to start. Creating Hello World is going to be very simple, but you will learn pretty much instantly a couple of very important concepts. So here, let's just jump in. We have our development environment, which is really just a page. It is a web page. It can render on a mobile phone. Doesn't matter. Let's just say it is a page, and that page may have logic. So the logic that we want to put into this page is when it runs in the browser or a mobile phone. It's going to be easier to check in the browser. But anyway, when it runs in the browser, it prints out Hello World somewhere, and we will get to it where it actually prints out. But the point is that we will add logic using Codeless to do just that. How do you do it in Codeless? How do you do it in UI Builder? It's actually very simple. So here, there's already a couple of things that you get out of the box on that page, such as this header and there's this workspace. But what you need to do is to select the actual page. If you go to the outer boundary, and you will see it will say page right here. Click on it, and you will see this little icon right here. It looks like a jigsaw puzzle, and it's also going to be replicated on this side, and then the tooltip does say add logic. So click either here or click here, and you will switch to the environment. Well, it's part of the environment, and here you will see it says logic. So we will be spending a lot of time in this logic section. In fact, I think 99% of the time, as you go through these Codeless tutorials, you'll be spending your time in the logic tab. In here, just so you know, there are different events that occur in this page. Not very important right now, except for one thing. One of them says on page enter, and that's the event that is triggered when that page is loaded in the browser. Click on this green button right here, and you will get our very first Codeless kind of thingy, right? And what it is, this is the placeholder for the Codeless logic. And as you can see, it looks like, I don't know what it looks like, kind of a crooked horseshoe. But anyway, this is the placeholder where you will put Codeless logic. So in here, anything that is inside of that block is going to be the logic that is executed when the page is entered, when it loads up in the browser. What you will need to do is click on this add block and type in the word print. You will see this text print. And you get another one, which is this print guy. You can drag and drop and put it right inside. So in here, we'll already have some logic in place. And where it says ABC, just type in hello, Codeless world. Press enter. And that's all it's going to take. It's as simple as it is, and we will start getting into more complex things as you learn Codeless, but that's our first baby step. So what happens here is on page enter is the placeholder. Inside there is an instruction that says print, and it has the actual text that needs to be printed. Where do you see this text? Let me show this to you. So in here you will see on the right hand side a little icon that if you move the mouse over, it says desktop preview. When you click this icon, a new page opens up, and I'm just gonna move this page so I have both our development environment shown and the actual page. And right now, yes, nothing shows up, nothing is printed. Guess what? Whenever you use this print block, it actually prints to browser console. And browser console is not instantly displayed. You actually need to get to it. So if what you do is you right click on that second browser, second tab that opened up, right click and select inspect. That's how it works in Chrome. In other browsers, there is going to be different way how to get to the browser console. And this panel opens up, switch to console. Guess what? Here's our Hello Codeless world. So anytime you use the print block, it will be displayed right here. So this is going to be kind of this visual feedback that we will use many times throughout these lectures. And eventually we'll get to the point where we'll be displaying it right on the page itself. However, from the perspective of learning Codeless, That's going to be our mechanism to get information from the logic. In fact, if you reload this page, then this is cleared, the page is reloaded, and then this is printed again. So congratulations, we just completed our very first task of using print block and displaying it in the browser console. I hope you found this useful. Thank you, and as always, happy Codeless coding.